Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1768. Do a math equation in Excel. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. The other day I was watching Twitter and a question came across about how to enter an equation in Excel. And here's the equation that we're trying to do. Boy, I used to be really good at math and it's been a while. So this is pi. This is the mathematical constant e. So it really comes down to, you know, how do we do the pi? How do we do the e? How do we do the square root? It looks like we're trying to solve for r and we have an input cell of z. At least that's how I read it. Now, it's been a long time since I was really good at math, so I may have this completely wrong. But here's what we do. So we equal 1 divided by, that handles the 1 divided by, and then we want the square root, sqrt, of 2 times pi. Pi, you have to put open parenthesis and close parenthesis afterward. Alright, so right now, I think we have this first part of the equation modeled right there, and then we're going to multiply that times. Okay, the mathematical constant E in Excel is the exp of 1. So E is exp of 1, and we're going to raise that to, I'm going to put it all in parentheses, minus 1 half, so minus 0.5 times Z is this value over here in A2 squared, so caret 2 is the way to square that. And let's see, there's our answer. Double click to copy that down. You have to provide some z values here, and part of the trick is figuring out what the valid range of z values are. These numbers here are incredibly small, so it looks like once we get past 4, it pretty much tails off to 0. Let's start this here at minus 4. And I have equations here that go basically from 4, minus 4 down to positive 4. We'll take a look and see how this looks. We'll select our data, the original z values and the r values. Insert, I'll do a scatter chart, the smooth one. All right, so you'll have to, if you know what this equation is supposed to be doing, you can take a look at this chart and see if that is roughly the right value. So there you go. Excel is great at doing formulas, but when you have an equation like this, it's a little bit tricky figuring out the square root, how to square something, how to raise something to another power, how to do the pi, and the e constant. So there you have it. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.